So, hello friends. Today I will discuss about the most important topic in molecular genetics and for association mapping, which is linked disequilibrium. Many messages comes for me, many students put their questions regarding linked disequilibrium in my comment box. So finally I came into this topic, linked disequilibrium. So hello friends, good morning all of you. This is Vikas Mangal, scientist, genetics and plant breeding, Krijef, Barakpur. Now coming to the linkage disequilibrium, and this is represented by this LD. Okay, so this is also called GPD, the gametic phase disequilibrium. Okay, please note down these points. This is also called the gametic phase disequilibrium. It means this is ultimately related to the some gametes. Now what is the definition of linkage disequilibrium? It is the non-random association of allele. Non-random association of allele at different loci in a given population. First thing is important, this term is used for the population, not for the individual. This term is used for the population. So before discussing this slide, I will discuss this slide, linkage and linkage disequilibrium. Actually some students are confused because linkage disequilibrium is related to the linkage. It is like linkage, but there is some basic differences, linkage and linkage disequilibrium. What? Alleles of two genes are inherited together because they are located close to each other in the same chromosome. So this is called linkage. What is linkage? For having a linkage, the genes should be present on the same physical location. If they are inherited together, then this is called linked. Suppose genes are not present on the same physical chromosome and they are inherited together. So this, now we can't use the term linkage for this. So here the terms come, linkage disequilibrium. It means, that's why this definition come, non-random association of between alleles of two loci in a population. That's why we are using the term population. Irrespective, this term is also important, of their physical location in the genome. Because for linkage disequilibrium, the allele should not have physical location, same physical location in the genome. If they don't have same physical location, then they can inherit it together, and this is called linkage disequilibrium. Okay, it means linkage between loci would generate LD. It is correct. Linkage between loci, because the term linkage means inherited together. Linkage between loci would generate LD, but significant LD can be observed when unlinked genes due to epistatic selection. But LD can be observed between unlinked genes which are not linked, but they are inherited together due to the some epistatic selection. This is actually linked disequilibrium. That's why this term is more important. Okay, now coming to the slide. So as a result, after LD, as a result, the allelic combination of the concerned loci observed in the population deviates significantly from their frequency expected on the basis of independent assortment. It means, generally, we assume that independent assortment occur between the concerned loci, but this allelic combination of the concerned loci differed from their independent segregation due to this linkage disequilibrium. In generally, when independent segregation occur, then this PAB, the frequency of AB in a population equal to their separate frequency multiply PA into PB. But suppose linkage disequilibrium is there, then it will not equal to their individual frequency, multiplication of the individual frequency. If independent segregation is there, then this, the coupling, this is the coupling and this is the repulsion. The coupling and repulsion, the frequency of coupling and repulsion zygote will be same, but if LD is there, this will not same. Now you can say ki what is linkage disequilibrium. It is also represented by D. Okay, I will discuss very detail. It means the difference between the coupling gamete and the repulsion gamete, it is called linkage disequilibrium. From this you can conclude or draw this formula, the difference between these coupling gamete and repulsion gamete, it is D, because they are not same when linkage disequilibrium is occur. First we will see the case of independent segregation. Okay, suppose allele A, capital A and small a is there, this having gene 1A, and they having one gene, frequency 0.4, 0.6 assume. Okay, when you will calculate the frequency of AB, it will be multiply of 0.4 and 0.7, so 0.28, and capital एन स्मॉल बी 7 × 6 4 2 ओके दिस एंड द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ कैपिटल बी दिस 0.4 दिस इज ओके दिस इज 0.6 एंड दिस हैविंग 0.7 0.3 ओके सपोज दे आर इन इंडिपेंडेंस एग्रीगेशन एंड नॉट हैविंग एनी लिंकेज डिसइक्विलिब्रियम ओके सो दिस विल बी इक्वल टू दिस और नॉट वी विल चेक ओके हियर इंडिपेंडेंस एग्रीगेशन ऑफ जीन सो फॉर इंडिपेंडेंस एग्रीगेशन ऑफ जीन दिस कंडीशन शुड बी फॉलो सो वी विल चेक तो पी ए बी द वैल्यू ऑफ पी ए बी इज 0.28 ओके एंड वैल्यू ऑफ पी स्मॉल ए बी इज 0.18 सो दिस इज 0.28 और 0.12 ओके ओके एंड 60 18 एक्चुअली देर आर सम मिस्टेक्स आर देयर हेयर हाँ दिस इज 0.18 ओके दिस इज 0.18 ओके आई राइट मिस्टेकली दिस इज 0.18 वाई बिकॉज दिस इज 0.18 एंड दिस इज 0.42 एंड 0.12 सो दिस इज द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ दिस 0.4212 वैन यू मल्टीप्लाई दिस दिस विल कम 0.0504 देन यू मल्टीप्लाई दिस विल कम 0.05 इट मीन्स वैन इंडिपेंडेंस एग्रीगेशन ऑफ जीन इज देयर द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ दिस कपलिंग गैमिट इज इक्वल टू द रिपल्सन गैमिट हियर यू कैन सी सो इट मीन्स वैन यू सब्सट्रैक्ट दिस द जीरो विल कम इट मीन्स जीरो लिंकेज डिसइक्विलिब्रियम मीन्स द इंडिपेंडेंस एग्रीगेशन ऑफ जीन ओके नाउ कमिंग टू द सम इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इन ईच जनरेशन ऑफ रेंडम मैटिंग द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ एल डी विल डिक्लाइन ओके सपोज हेयर एल डी इज देयर ओके एल डी इज देयर बट एल डी इज डिस्टर्ब बाई रिकॉम्बिनेशन बिकॉज इट इज अगेंस्ट द इंडिपेंडेंस एग्रीगेशन ऑफ रिकॉम्बिनेशन सो इट मीन द लिंकेज डिसइक्विलिब्रियम विल डिस्टर्ब बाई रिकॉम्बिनेशन सो इफ रिकॉम्बिनेशन विल अकर इन रेंडम मैटिंग पॉपुलेशन देन डी विल डिक्लाइन सो इट विल डिक्लाइन अकॉर्डिंग टू द वॉट एवर रिकॉम्बिनेशन इज अकर सो इन ईच जनरेशन ऑफ रेंडम मैटिंग द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ डी विल डिक्लाइन बाय द वैल्यू ऑफ आर डी तो स्मॉल आर मीन्स रिकॉम्बिनेशन और डी मीन्स लिंकेज डिसइक्विलिब्रियम सो इट विल डिक्लाइन द वैल्यू ऑफ आर डी वेयर आर द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ रिकॉम्बिनेशन बिटवीन द टू लोसाई नाउ एल डी बिटवीन टू लोसाई एंड दिस पॉइंट वेन दिस लिंकेज डिसइक्विलिब्रियम विल डिक्लाइन दिस इज कॉल्ड एक्चुअली एल डी डिके दिस इज कॉल्ड एल डी डिके दिस टर्म इज ऑल्सो इंपॉर्टेंट लिंकेज डिसइक्विलिब्रियम और एल डी एल डी बिटवीन टू लोसाई डिके सो एल डी बिटवीन टू लोसाई डिके इट वो टेम्परली टेम्परली मीन्स वेन द जनरेशन एडवांस जनरेशन एडवांस मीन्स जनरेशन एडवांस मीन्स वेन इट विल गो थ्रू एफ वन टू एफ टू सो इन बिटवीन एफ वन एफ टू रिकॉम्बिनेशन अकर सो एल डी विल डिक्लाइन वेन यू विल गो एफ टू टू एफ थ्री सो एल डी विल डिक्लाइन वेन यू विल गो एफ थ्री टू एफ फोर देन एल डी विल डिक्लाइन सो दिस इज कॉल्ड दिस इज जनरेशन एडवांस सो एल डी डिके बोथ टेम्पोरली एज द जनरेशन एडवांस एंड स्पेशियली मीन्स विद द इंक्रीजिंग डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द टू लोसाई बिकॉज बिटवीन वेन द बिटवीन टू लोसाई सपोज ए लोसाई एंड स्मॉल एयर एंड डिफरेंट लोसाई इज देयर वेन द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दीज टू लोसाई विल इंक्रीज देन क्रॉसिंग ओवर और रिकॉम्बिनेशन और इंडिपेंडेंस एग्रीगेशन विल इंक्रीज वेन एंड लिंकेज डिसइक्विलिब्रियम इज इनडायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू द दिस एल डी इज इनडायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू द क्रॉसिंग ओवर और इंडिपेंडेंस एग्रीगेशन यू कैन सी एनीथिंग सो वेन वेन द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू लोसाई विल इंक्रीज द क्रॉसिंग ओवर दिस इज क्रॉसिंग ओवर विल इंक्रीज क्रॉसिंग ओवर विल इंक्रीज देन एल डी विल डिक्रीज सो इट मीन्स द रीजन ऑफ एल डी डिके इट कैन बी टेम्पोरली और इट कैन बी स्पेशियली ओके म्यूटेशन हाउ म्यूटेशन अफेक्ट दिस लिंकेज डिसइक्विलिब्रियम नाउ वी हैव वन मार्कर इट हैविंग एलील कैपिटल ए एंड स्मॉल ए एंड दिस इज जीन दिस कैपिटल बी कैपिटल देर इज नो सच म्यूटेशन इट मीन्स द मार्कर हैज टू एलील कैपिटल स्मॉल ए बट द जीन हैज ओनली सिंगल एलील वी नाउ म्यूटेशन विल अकर इट मीन्स म्यूटेशन विल अकर मीन्स कैपिटल बी विल चेंज टू इट द आफ्टर म्यूटेशन वाट विल हैपन आफ्टर म्यूटेशन द वन जीन क्रिएट इट्स डिफरेंट एलील सो बी विल क्रिएट स्मॉल बी एलील ओके सो म्यूटेशन अकर इन द जीन बी एंड प्रोड्यूस द एलील बी सो दिस म्यूटेशन अकर इन द क्रोमोसोम हैविंग द हैप्लोटाइप ए बी ओके म्यूटेशन अकर ओनली द this haplotype, capital A and capital B. So that's why the different copy come. This is same, small A and capital B. The capital A and small B come because capital B mutate to small B, and this mutation occur only in one haplotype, capital A, capital B. Okay, this up now three haplotype is possible here. What haplotype? Capital A, capital B. Okay, next haplotype, capital A, small B, and third haplotype, small A and capital B. Now three haplotype is possible. So this yield three haplotype for two locus. Allele B will always be present within marker allele A, and LD will be very high. Now this small B will always go with capital A because here LD is high. LD high because there is no such recombination occur. Now you can ask a question ki why small A and V is not forming, because here there is no such recombination. When recombination will occur, then this A will come through this small B. This A and V come together when recombination occur, but here no recombination is occur. Now coming to the next. Now you can see this fourth haplotype produced. So why it is produced? Crossing over take place between the chromosome with haplotype capital A, small B and small A. Crossing over here, this crossing over occur between the haplotype capital A, small B and small A, capital B. So this generate the fourth haplotype small AB. The magnitude of LD will decline. Now magnitude of LD will decline because the crossing over is happening. So crossing over is opposite to the linkage disequilibrium. Now you can see, obviously the magnitude of LD will be greater in the case of more recently produced mutant allele than in the case of those producing relative distance. This point is more important. Please try to understand the concept behind this. Suppose ki what they are saying ki the magnitude of LD will be greater in the case of more recently produced mutant allele. Here you can see, here no crossing over is occur, it means LD is high. But here different alleles, here LD is less, it means LD will be greater in case of more recently produced mutant allele. Why it is LD high? Because LD will be greater in case of more recently produced mutant allele than in the case of those producing relatively distant past. This term is most important. Now how you will measure the linkage disequilibrium? Okay, first some things are important for example, concept of LD given by Jennings in 1970, but this scientist Levantin developed his estimation in 1964. Ultimately Levantin contribute more about in linkage disequilibrium. So this LD, the three estimation of LD are there. You can represent by capital D, capital D dash and capital R, small r square. In capital D some drawbacks are there, that's why capital D dash is reduce, and in capital D dash some drawback are there, that's why we need this small r square. Okay, so why we need this capital D dash if we have already this capital D? I already told, actually the value of D, I already discussed, this value of D depends on the allele frequency. The value of D, here you can see this value of D is depend on the allele frequency. The value of D depends on allele frequency. Allele with frequency lower than 5% or even 10% are generally not included in estimation of D. These things are important. The drawback of capital D, actually the value of D depends on the allele frequency, and alleles with frequency lower than 5% or 10%, they are not included in estimation of D. That's why we need this D dash and R square, and we all know that D dash and R square are the most relevant estimate. D dash and R square are the most relevant estimate of LD for plant species. Okay, this D dash concept, actually this is also given by Levantin 1964. So this D dash is the standardized version of capital D. This D dash is standardized version of capital D calculated. How you will calculate small d? With the help of capital D. So you will calculate the D dash by dividing D, this D, divided D with its maximum possible value obtainable from the given allele frequency at the two loci. So these are most important for PhD student, but not for UG student or even master student. So this is the formula of capital D dash. Okay, when you divide this capital D with this, when the value of DAV is this, you can note only this point. Okay, these are some higher concept. Why and the range of this capital D is, these can be asked in any exam, 0 to 1. So suppose the value of capital D dash is 1, it means the complete linkage disequilibrium is there. Then why we need this small r square if we have D dash? Because this capital D dash, this is influenced by the small sample size, particularly for loci with rare alleles. This is the drawback of capital D dash, because it is influenced by small sample size, particularly for loci with rare alleles. That's why now we need this r square. So the value of square of the estimate of correlation r, we all know r is the correlation. So the value of square of the estimate of correlation coefficient between the alleles of two genes gives the estimate of r square. It is range 0 to 1. Suppose this r square have 0, it means this is independent segregation. And the formula of r square is this. This is the independent allele frequency. In this formula, this is independent allele frequency. Okay. And this is capital D AV square. This is the formula. You can note down only this formula. Okay. Now comparison of capital D dash and R square. Okay. So we all know that D dash and R square are most widely used measures of LDI, already discussed. So D dash, this term is more important for molecular genetics student. This D dash, this measure only the recombination history. This measure only the recombination history. But R square, this reflect both mutation and recombination history. Please note down this point. Okay. This D dash measure only the recombination history, but small r square measure both mutation and the recombination history. Okay. And this D dash, this is more reliable estimate of physical distance between loci, because others two are dependent on allele frequency. Okay. Definitely capital D dash is dependent on the allele frequency. That's why capital D is dependent on the allele frequency, and capital D dash is better than capital D. And where is r square is better? When more reliable under low allele frequency. Low allele frequency is there, then small r square is better. Okay. In general, r square seems to the most reliable estimate. Ultimately, this r square is the most reliable estimate. In general, r square seems to be the most appropriate measure of LD for association mapping. Usually, r square value 1/3, okay, are considered to be useful for LD mapping. So this is the linkage disequilibrium. This is the really a most important concept. And thank you all of you for watching our video.